honorable speaker, what is it that brought you to South Africa? Because I understand you came here just for one day, just for a day.
Well, not exactly. It was like more like 5 days or
yes.
6 days.
Yeah.
But I'm staying just 2 more days.
Yes.
And flying back on Wednesday. Well, this actually tomorrow I'm flying back. Tomorrow
okay.
evening, on Wednesday evening I'm flying back.
Yes.
And, you know, my plan was actually just to work for 2 days, for the weekend, for Saturday and Sunday. But there was this conference where I was allowed to be on stage as a speaker.
Yes.
And then my plan was to just hang out in the pool and go to the gym and maybe
yes.
be in the sun. But what happened then is that so many people on the news from the media, from radio stations, from TV stations, they heard about this speaker award that I won and contacted me.
Yes.
So now I'm traveling all around and I'm very excited about the effect that this event has. So I'm
yes.
a bit surprised.
Yes.
And I'm very happy. I'm very happy and thankful for the chance I'm given to share my ideas here
yes.
via the radio, for example.
Yeah. So tell us, since here in Cosmo City, like I said, this show is special for young people, you know, and
yes.
young adults.
Yes.
We have a lot of high schools here.
Oh.
Yeah, the high schools, you know. So what is it that you, in particular, that you can do to impact young people around here, since you are working hand in hand with your partner this side?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
To young people, well...
To everyone, because
yes.
Cosmo City is booming with small businesses.
Yes.
Yes. So... It's
okay.
like, yeah.
Yeah. Here's my idea.
Yeah.
A lot of people think that what you should do is go through high school and
yes.
then, you know, maybe go and keep on studying.
Yes.
And I disagree. This is what I did.
Yes.
But a lot of people I know, extremely successful business people,
yes.
they dropped out of high school, they dropped out of college, they dropped out of university.
Yes.
So I think what is relevant is not necessarily if you follow the normal, you know, the normal path.
Yes.
But what I think really matters is find your own path, create
yes.
your own path.
Yes.
And you know, thinking this a little bit further, create your own career, create your own job.
Yes.
Don't even ask for unemployment. In my life, I've written very few applications.
Yes.
And a lot of people think, okay, to get a job, you need to have a good resume, you have to have a good CV, and then
yes.
you apply, then you look for vacancies, and then you apply. I think this is no longer true.
Mm.
I think in today's world, what makes people successful is if they create their own job. So be creative. There are so many jobs that you can create yourself.
Yeah.
I think you should be a job maker, not a job seeker.
Well, yes.
And then the very best is if you then continue creating jobs for other people.
Yes.
And you offer employment to others.
Yes.
Yeah? So this is the very best you can do for others, because then you're really giving something back to society.
Yes.
So be creative. It's crazy how many chances there are, especially here in this country. I see there's a lot of problems.
Yes.
But if we reframe it and say, look, we don't have problems, we have opportunities.
Yes. Okay.
And every problem we have, change it into a business opportunity.
Opportunity.
Let's talk about the crime situation. If you think this is a problem, I think this is great.
Yeah.
Because then you can work as a security company, for example.
Yeah.
You offer security solutions that you wouldn't be able to sell in other countries.
Yes.
Where this doesn't exist.
Yes.
So it's a mind shift. Try to see solutions. Try to see the opportunities that you have, and don't complain about what the problems are.
Yes.